Welcome to a Spellbinders video tutorial. Today we'll be making a layout using Spellbinders 3D emboss abilities called Creative Cogs and Spellbinders Nest Abilities Labels 1. Now to begin, we're going to be using the 3D emboss abilities folder as you see here, and we're going to emboss three different colors of cardstock, starting with orange. Then we will emboss the same pattern using blue and then green. And here we'll end up with the three identical copies of the Creative Cogs. Now there's three, almost four levels of embossing here, so you might have to press a little bit hard and take an ink pad. And the ink pad I've chosen is really just a little darker than the cardstock. So you might have to press down a little bit and get into those deeper set areas of the embossed pattern. And our last one here is green, and this is a very easy technique to really get at those raised cogs. Okay, after we're finished this inking, what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep the orange piece all in one, and I'm going to mat it onto a piece of black cardstock. The green and the blue, I'm going to cut that embossed pattern up into chunks, and then I'm also going to mat those little pieces onto black paper. And I'll end up having a bunch of pieces that I can use for color blocking and making up a really funky background using those nice bright colors. So here what I'm doing is adhering all my little pieces to a piece of black cardstock, and then I will take it to my guillotine cutter and trim them to maybe about a quarter of an inch overlap on each end of the frame. So once you've had all your matted pieces, you can play around with them on the layout, see how you'd like your design to be. When I do a project like this, I tend to keep all of the color in the middle, and I like all the white space around the edge of the layout, and that kind of keeps it framed and focused in the center. For my last piece, I want to use my Labels 1 Nest Ability, and because they come in so many different sizes, this is a trick I do. I take many of the sizes of my Nest Abilities and I try to see which size really fits. So I've chosen one of the smaller sizes, and I'm going to cut a piece of Spellbinders foil. And I will emboss it as well and sand it just so I can get some texture, some distressing on this beautiful orange foil. And this will be used to put a monogram on, an M. So before you glue, here's an opportunity to just really play around with the exact position of your shapes. Make sure the colors are all blending, that it looks good, that your photo matches. And what you're looking at now is the final layout. Thanks for watching. Supply list is coming at the end. Have a great day.